Hi again. This is the second of three tutorials in which we are designing a real application for a shop using Signum framework. Let's open framework map to see where we are and what are we going to do now. Here it is. In the previous tutorial, we finished modeling the entities. Now it's time to create a database, write some business logic, load some data, and finally set up the server. So we are going to focus mainly in this area. Close this. And let's try to compile. Oops, we have 4 errors, but they are mainly produced by these 3 projects, so let's just unload the projects and we will solve the problems later. We compile again, and now we have 2 errors only. Let's focus on that. In Signum logic, the template has created the starter. The starter is just a static class that is used to, well, start the engine. It does that by collecting all the entities we want in the database using an schema builder. And finally, it produces an schema object as a result. An schema object is a logical in-memory representation of your database. And for Signum engine to start, you need the connection string and the schema object. The compiler is not finding the example entity. Let's just use or there instead. We don't have to include every single entity we are using. If we include only the root of our entities, Schema Builder will explore the dependencies and produce a consistent view of the database. We don't have an implemented by all attribute, but usually including type DN is a good idea. We can get rid of the nodes, however. Okay, let's see if it compiles now. Oops, another problem in the loading application. The loading application is just a console application for loading data and other admin tasks. It's initially created with a menu with 4 different options. Create a new database, generate a synchronization script, load data, and exit. Load data is trying to instantiate some myEntity objects, and the class no longer exists, so just let's comment this out, and let's try to build it. Cool, now it compiles successfully. We make load or starting application, just hit F5. Before creating the DB schema, we have to create a database in SQL Management Studio. So let's just close this for a second. And let's first take a look to appconfig. And as you see, the template have already created a connection string pointing to a sub database in localhost. So let's just create it. Databases, new database, shop. Here we go. Okay, we just hit F5 again and 1 for new database. Hey, we have a new database now. Okay, let's see the results. We open SQL Management Studio. Yeah. Databases, shop. And here we have all the tables. Let's create a new diagram with all the tables and we lay out like this. As you see, there is an evident parallelism between the entities we model and the generated tables. Every entity has an ID and a toString field, even state that is an enum. Orderline is an embedded entity. That's why instead of toString, it has a back reference to order to enable a many-to-many relationship. Also look at the double foreign key to person and company that have been created. Let's start loading some data. In the desktop, I have an Excel file with some products, just some toys and their prices. Let's save it as a CSV file. Let's do the same with customer field, just some friends of mine and some companies of the family. And we save it as a CSV file. Yep, save. Okay, we turn back to Visual Studio and we are going to include these files in the loading application. Yep, customers and products. Okay. Remember to make them copy always. Signum Utilities makes it really easy to open a CSV file. You only have to make a class like this one that matches the columns of the file. It's going to be customer CSV. With all these fields. Okay. Let's start loading the products. We can get rid of this and products. Okay, the first thing we do is to load the product from the CSV file. So product equals CSV dot read of product, product CSV. Then we use select to transform it to product entities. So products dot select, and we use an object initializer taking care of the price because it has a currency symbol. And we can use database save list to save all the products at once. We can make it simple moving this down. And we can get rid of this line. Also, since save list is defined in database as an extension method, we can write it more conveniently like this. We move this to the end of the line. And we can remove the variable declaration. We copy this and start loading the customers. Customers and customer. Now it's a bit more complicated. Depending if the row has a company name, we have to create the new company with address and phone, email and company name, or a person with first and last name. Okay, let's just copy this and we're going to load the employees. We're going to instantiate the object just here and use the save extension method. Okay, yeah, just the cheapest employees I found. We hit F5, 3-4 load data, and oops, company name. Yeah, some string length validator is not allowing BP to get in, so we change this. F5 again. New database, yeah, 3-4 load data, and now everything loads correctly. Let's move to business logic. In SOAP logic, we are going to create a new class, and it's going to be order logic. So a static class and create or modify order. Okay. If the order state is not ordered, throw obligation exception. Otherwise, just save. Can use extension method instead. To pay the order, we can use a lazy of order instead. This way we save bandwidth and we retrieve the order. Okay. If the order state is not order, throw a new step in. Otherwise, change the state to paid and just save. And run with a transaction. Look how easy. Okay, we copy this and let's do ship order. It has to be paid and the state will be ship. We have to set also the ship date to daytime. No, we forget to do the same in create or modify. Perfect. Okay, this compiles now, so we have the logic now. Let's move the methods to the service interface, so we have to load SOAP services. Just the same methods, but don't forget to use the contract attributes. Okay, so it compiles now. Okay, now it's time for the service implementation. We load SOAP web, and let's just implement the interface. We use execute method info get current method and just a lambda calling the logic method. We copy this for ship order and pay order and let's see if it works now. Oops, we have a problem with our example query. Let's just comment this out and we will see next tutorial. We make SOAP web our startup project. And let's see if it works. Whoa, it looks like we have a server now and we are just 10 minutes away from a fully functional shop application. See you in next tutorial. Thank you for listening.